Okay, so we just finished the third solo, which started over the bridge, completed that solo, and then the song goes back into the chorus the same amount of times as the other choruses. Coming out of this final chorus, we're going to be into the final and fourth solo of the song. So, this is going to be a long solo, so we'll take this in sections. The first section sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so I'm starting here on the B, on the low E string, going back from the 7th fret, which is the note B, to the 5th fret, and then back to the B. Climbing up the B minor scale, B, C sharp, D. Moving into 7th position, I'm going to play a double stop, 7th fret, the G and the B string. Coming down to the D string, 9 to 7. So far we've done this. Okay, now a little bluesy bend. G string, 9th fret, bend up a full step. Play 7 on the B and E. Come back down 10th fret to the 7th fret on the B. So far we've done this. Now I'm going to bend up on the 10th fret of the B, back down. Okay, so here's that first little section again. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, next section. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm starting on B, 12th fret of the E string, bending up a step and a half. So I'm trying to reach the note D, and I'm going to do that bend 2 times. Now I'm going to bend on the 12th fret of the E up a full step. Come back down, 12 to 10, back to 12. Okay, so far in this little second section, we've done this. Next part sounds like this. So that's a bend 12 on the high E string. Come back down. 10 to 12 on the high E. 10 on the E. Finally landing on 12 on the B. So from the beginning, here's what we've done. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, next section. So that's just going back and forth between the G string and the B string on the 7th fret. Okay, next part sounds like this. So what I'm doing here is I'm bending on the 12th fret on the high E string. Bend up a full step and come back down. Hammer on and pull off down between 10, 12, 9, 10, and then back to 7th fret on the high E. So far we've done this. Then I'm going to hammer on to the 9th fret, back to the 7th. 10th fret, pull off to the 7th. So far we've done this. And then I'm going to start this hammer-on section. While holding the 7th fret of the high E, my right hand is going to play on the high E string, 12, 14, 12, 14. 15, 14, 15. So far I've done this. Seventeen, fifteen, seventeen, nineteen, and then slide and bend on the 21st fret with your left hand. Bend that up a half step. Okay. Next part sounds like this. Okay, so what I'm doing here is kind of outlining the melody, the main melody of the chorus of the song. Starting on D, which is the fifth fret of the A string. Sliding up from 7 to 9 on the D, back to 7, 9 on the A, back to 7 on the D, 9, 7, 5 on the A. So that phrase together sounds like this. 2, 3, 4. Okay, now we're going to start on the 5th fret of the A string and play this. So it's like half of that phrase. So 5th fret of the A string, 9th fret of the D, 7th fret of the D, 9A, back to 7D. Okay. And finally, we're going to end up with a little harmony part. Sounds like this. 2, 3, 4, 1. So that's playing D, 10th fret of the E string, an octave above that, 12th fret of the D, 11 D, 9, back to 12 on the D, landing on 9A. And the harmony sounds like this. So that's starting on the 7th fret of the D, up to the 11 G, back to 9, 7 to 9, landing on 7 D. So that harmony goes with this part. Okay, and then finally we're just going to play a single note B, which you can do on the 4th fret of the G string. Okay, so now I'm going to go back and try and put all of these solo pieces together for the final solo. And keep in mind that in the studio there's a lot of different guitars that kind of overlap, so this is going to be a composite of all these parts. Here we go. 1, 2, 3.